Good day, everyone. So I'll be discussing the topic on string data type and the functions associated with the string type. First, let us define what is a string data type. So a string is a sequence of characters. These are text that are, or string literals, this, that are appearing in your program. So a string literal uses quotes. So anything enclosed in single quotes or double quotes, these are considered strings. Now, when to use double quote, this is needed if your string contains a single quote. So in order to include a single quote as part of the string, it must be enclosed in two double quotation marks. So by default, any of this will work. It's up to you on which is more appropriate in your program. So these are examples on the right side. You have this str equals hello. str2 equals there. Okay, so the third statement is Bob is equal to str1 plus str2, and then print Bob. So what does the plus sign do when applied to strings? So the plus sign is used to concatenate strings. So I think everyone knows how concatenation works. You're simply appending or combining strings using the plus sign. So to try this one, I'd have to run Python. Okay, so you might want to use other IDEs. Okay, in my case, let me try using the command line Python. Okay, so I have here. So let's declare a string variable or a variable, and then we assign a string value. So hello, for example. Okay, so it is stored on the str1 variable. Str2 is equal to a single quote there. Okay, and then I'll have to perform the concatenation. Bob equals str1 plus str2. I'm applying the plus sign, string concatenation to strings. So, and then let's print Bob. Okay, so I have there hello there. Now if you want that, you can add space here if you want the space on the output. Okay, so for example, these are common errors, no, in programming, wherein you directly perform addition. Yeah, say for example, gikan sa input ninyo, and then you want to add a value to that input. Take note that in input in Python, all input in Python are considered strings. Okay, bisan pa og numbers ang inyong gi-assign, gisulod sa inyong input or sa variable, okay, without casting it to become another type or converting the data type of the value, then ang default niya na is consider ginit niya as string. Example, I'll have here x is equal to x is equal to I'll use the input. Okay, input, enter a value, for example. Okay, so let's say, so kanisa karon, this is considered to be string, even though ang input line is 1, 2, 3. Okay, and then I'll have y is equal to x plus 5, for example. Now when I hit enter, error na siya automatically. Why? It's because you're trying to add a string to a numeric value in this case. So kaning x karon, which is a string, 1, 2, 3, imong gusto nta is 123 plus 5, supposed to be 1 to output. You want to assign y 128, then this is applicable. It's because ang data type is you're adding a string and an integer. So to correct this, you can either convert, you have to convert the data type of x, okay, using the int method. Okay, you can have it like this, equals int, okay, it's int x plus 5. Okay, so So wala na error, and then I could now print y with a value of 128. So kailangan gid sa i-convert before you can perform arithmetic operations. Kaya again, ang basic input ani sa, especially if you're using the input method, ang iyang i-treat to niya ang tanan input, whether ga contain o numeric nga input, example 1 2 3 or 4 5 6 or any numeric input, pero gipaagi ninyo sa input without converting it to another type, then it is considered to be a string. So mao gyud na sa ang kasagara ng mga errors, no, adding, you're performing the concatenation to a non-string value or data types. Okay, so let's proceed. So reading and converting strings, now you can actually convert it right away upon input by simply i-cast na to daan, convert na to using the int method. So just like the example before, so I'll have it, so okay lang kung imuhang input is text gud siya, then you don't have to convert it. Pero kung numeric imong i-treat nimo siya as numeric, then you have to convert it to the data type, to the numeric type imong kailangan. So example, let's try this one. So name is equal to input. Okay, you have here enter. Okay, so pwede na siya. I could enter my name. Okay, so I could have print name. Okay, then that's the value of the name variable. I could have apple is equal to input. Okay, you have enter the number of apples, for example. Okay, enter the number of apples. Uy, apra, sorry. Apples, say for example, 50. Okay, so again, the app variable contains a value or a string 50. So I could diha po nato pwede i-perform ang arithmetic operations or mga basic mathematical operations is because string type na siya, not to correct. As I mentioned, we have to convert it to the appropriate numeric type. So example, x is equal to app minus 5, error na siya automatically. You're performing a minus sign to subtraction to a string type. So again, ito yung correct niya, x is equal to, could have it converted int, now int app minus 5, then you have there print x, you have there 45. So I have pa siya to perform once na convert na siya to the appropriate data type. Okay, so maybe some of you are using kanang mga IDEs. Now I'm trying to show you nga dito ta sa command line, since the example in the lecture slide is performing Python codes in the command line, but you can do this using your IDEs, or maybe some of you also don't have their computers or laptops at home, so pwede gud gihapon katong online lang ng mga interpreter compilers sa Python, but we can also run this using the Visual Studio Code. Pwede kaya po sa dire, if you want. So, pwede po nato ipadagan na itong programs dire, just like the examples of Mr. Pasok before. So, pwede po nato sa dire. So, I could do it here. Example, apple is equal to input. Example, we have here, enter the number of apples. Okay, it's stored in the variable apple, so left is equal to, say, apple, let's have 10, for example, is equal. So input, how many did you eat, for example? Okay, and then I could have here remaining apple is equal to, again, these are all treated as strings, apple, the apple and eaten variable. I could not perform apple minus eaten. Okay, this would perform an error. Okay, so I still need to cast this one int. Okay, and then I could have here int. Hang on, okay, so I will display here print apples, total apples. Okay, and then you have the plus. So apple, print eaten apples, apples, for example. Okay, plus eaten, and then you have print remaining apples. So this time around, I could have remaining. I could convert this to str to remaining. Remaining. Okay. So I could run this. Okay. Total number of apples. I could have 25. How many did you eat? So let's say 4. So I have here total apples 5, eaten apples 4, remaining apples 21. So as you can see in the code, so I have here, this input is considered to be a string. This one is also a string. So these two variables holds a numeric value, but having a string data type. Now, in performing the subtraction, I have panako siya gi-convert to integer. Okay? I have panako siya convert to integer. So, ang apple karon na string, na-convert na to int. Gi-minus na po na to sa eaten ng apples, gi-convert to int. Now, of course, the remaining variable would have an int data type since we're assigning the result of an integer operation na subtraction. So, basically, kaning remaining is int na niya. So, as you can see in the output, okay? As you can see in the printout, so total apples, wala na ko nag-convert. It's because this variable is already a string. So, pwede na ko mag-concatenate diretso using the apple variable at the same time the eaten variable. So wala na nako siya convert. Now this case, in this time around, there is a remaining since numeric ni siya, this is an integer. Now in order to display this, para makonkatenate na to siya sa remaining apples, ang mahitabuan ni karon class is that I have to convert the int data type to str para masumpay na to, para makonkatenate na to siya diri. Okay? So another method is ato ning i-comment. Another method is control C. Another method like this, control V, and then I have to comment this. So you can actually compare. Pwede po nga sa input na nato siya, ato siyang i-cast diretso. Naon? Diba? I-convert nato diretso int. So int po na siya. Now this time, so I would no longer cast this, baliktad noon siyang approach. It's up to you in which one do you prefer. So, kana siya. And then, this time around, kay int man ni siya, na-convert, dirita mag str. No, it should be str. And then, kanipod siya, str. Str, and then, str. So, kani siya karon, this would be integer ang result, the same, str gapon siya. So, this will have the same result. Okay, run the program. I have 5. So, eaten apples, 3. So, the remaining apples is 2. So, same result siya. Let me save it again. Okay, basin ka itong isa pang gidagan. Okay. Another 5. So, 4 ang giit. So, remaining apples is 1. So, it's up to you kung aha inyong i-prefer. Would it be better nga upon input atong i-convert down to integer? Or input na to as string, and then later on na to, kung kailangan ito mag-perform mga arithmetic operations, then I have to convert. So, it's It's up to you kung ahay mas i-prefer ninyo, but in it sa mga programmers nga mga idea is that it's better nga mag-input na mudaan og it's better nga para marag walay mga error later on nga encounter, it's better nga string daan ang input and then ayaw ninyo i-convert once kailangan ninyo i-convert. So treated siya basically nga string, so whether you want it to be displayed right away, pwede rin siya display, it's because it is a string na siya. So these are two ways on how to display or to convert, no? So bisan pag-asa imong gamiton ani, you have to nagi conversion gyapon nga mahitabo. If I'll use this one, string akong input, convert ko diri to integer, and then pag-abot diri, I would no longer convert this to string, it's because originally string gud siya based sa atong input. Nag-perform na to og calculation diri nga part. So kanilang siya nga part ang himo integer, ang remaining nga variable, and then that's the variable nga to siyang i-convert to str. Okay? So let's proceed. So reading and converting, so basically input in Python are treated as string if wala tay conversion nga gi dugang, just like this one sa tong code kaganiya, just like this one. Okay, kung wala tay conversion nga buhat upon input. Okay, so let's proceed. So looking inside string, so take note, since it is a sequence of characters, so there is a way in which we could get individual characters in given a string. It's because ang behavior aning strings class, it's just like an array of characters. So I don't know if array topic would be included in programming too, pero murag I'm sure it will be included in data structures later on. Okay, ang array nga topic, but kanisa nga idea mo, this is an array of characters nga kwan nga idea, wherein this one letter B has an index 0. So mo na siyang behavior sa array. Every element has an index. Now, but this is simply murag limited siya nga type sa array, is because 1:1 sa your index would be one character. One index corresponds to one character. And take note, kanisa class, the last character would be can be accessed using the length, okay? Length of the string, meaning kung pila ka buong character sa string, -1. Muna siya ang maximum index ng atong pwede ma-access. Okay, beyond that, it would be a runtime error na siya. Mo-access ta og, say, for example, banana ni example dere. Banana. So, how many characters do we have? We have 6 characters. Now, if you want to access individual characters, we can use that. We can access that through given the index, through the index of each character. And take note, the index starts at 0, always starts at 0, and ends with length -1. So the length is 6, -1, 5. That's the maximum index that we could, is murag allowable ng atong i-access. So, an index is specified using a square bracket. So, if, for example, the name of the variable is fruit, if I want to access the third character, that would be third is 3 -1, you get 2, index 2. So all you have to do is use the name of the variable, and then you specify the index. In this case, fruit 1, meaning it is letter A. So fruit 5, that would be letter B. Index is enclosed in square brackets. Okay? So that's how we can access every element or every character in a given string. Take note, ang space is also considered a character. So if you have a full name, example Charles Hanz V. Bautista, na space separated na siya, kanang space considered gihapon na siya nga character. Okay? So nana si corresponding gihapon nga code ang space. So we can only get at any single character in a string using an index specified in square brackets, just like this. So the index value must be an integer and starts at 0. So you notice it's 0 up to length minus 1. So again, you don't, you cannot access an out of bounds index. Dili pwede beyond, dili siya pwede og negative nga index. There's no such thing as a negative index. So index starts at 0 going to length minus 1. Length is the total number of characters on a given string, and you subtract 1 to that. Okay? So the index value can be an expression. Take note, an expression, meaning expression pwede na yung basic calculation, okay, that is computed. For example, in this, what's provided in the example, x is equals to 3, w is equal to fruit. Nani sa dere, fruit, okay? Fruit, x minus 1. So that would be 3 minus 1 would still give us a whole number nga result, meaning 2. So it will be index 2. So print W, the character at this particular index, it would be n. So let's try that using the command line lang ta para mas dali. Okay, so ako sang i-clear Python. Okay, so example, we have fruit is equal to let's say dragon. Apple, pineapple, example. Okay, so if I want to specify, get the third character, for example, is equal to, third car is equal to fruit, third car is 2. Okay, so print third car. Okay, you have n, meaning sa pineapple, you have, this is index 0, 1, 2. So, let's try to have a simple expression. Let's call this. Total is equal to, abusing len method, len fruit. The len method, it's provided in the succeeding slide. Okay, so total is len method. The len method would give us the total number of characters or the length of the string. So example, I would have print na tadit. So I would have fruit. Okay, I would have total. Okay, kung kaniso ang buhaton class, this would return an error. Error na siya. Why? Ang total is the total number of characters. Is 1, 2, 3, 4, plus 5 ang apple. 9 na siya. Ang total number of characters. Okay. So, we're trying to access fruit 9. So, in this example, fruit 9. So, fruit 9 would give us an error. Why? Out of range na siya. Kaya ang index would start from 0, 1, 2, going to 8 na siya. So, length is simply the total number of characters. Now, to correct this, okay, we're index out of bounds, pwede na to minusan og 1. Now, this would return the character E. Okay? So, length minus 1, or total minus 1. Okay? Total minus 1 is the length minus 1. It's character E. Okay? So, what I'm showing here is that we're performing a simple expression. Okay? Total minus 1 still would give us a valid index in the end. Okay, so total is 9 minus 1 would give us index fruit, at index 8 would give us the letter E. Okay, so hopefully everyone can follow, no? So let's proceed. So a character 2-4, this is what I just shown. Okay, I'm trying to access, given this example, I'm trying to access, ano to? I'm trying to access, ako leho na para mas klaro ha. Example, length is equal to 9, for example. Okay, I'll print 9. Ako, forget about length first nga method. Print fruit 9. Okay, the same rin sila. It's because ang value sa total is 9. Okay, we're trying to access index out of bounds. So, sa 9 ba manggaling, error na siya. How much more if I would go beyond I would input a much larger index. So out of bounds yun sa kanuna, it's because the length of pineapple, the total number of character, or the applicable index, or the allowable in the allowed index to be accessed is from 0 to 8 only. So in this case. So again, ang pwede siya is from 0 to 8 lang kay 9 ang number of characters. So this is the error in slide number 5. You will get a Python error if you attempt to index beyond the end of a string. Akong nangyong kagadina, there's no such thing as negative index. Pwede ba ta itong negative 1? So, what is negative 1? Minus 1, it goes back. So, if I have 2, L, pineapple. It's okay. Negative index in Python. Murag ni loop siya going backwards. Okay? So, negative 1. Kung tanaw na to, it's letter E. Letter L for negative 2. I would have negative 8. Let's try negative. That's I. Okay? Sa pine, pin. Okay? So, negative 9 would give us letter P. So, it's murag reverse ang kahitabo if you place a negative index. So that's a wrong statement before. Dili mo allow siya og negative index. I tried to mura og compare Python with other programming language wherein dili pwede ang negative index. So pwede sa Python only that gapabali siya. Okay? So ang bawal lang sa Python when it comes to accessing the index would be an index beyond the length. So, katong kagadina. So, if I have 10, for example, biyan na siya nga index on our string pineapple. Okay? So, akong ginapakita po, napakita na to, nga if you're trying to place a negative index, dito po siya padulong sa pabali. Now, if this case, atong ibutang negative 10, di na po siya pwede. Okay? So, negative 10, kung negative index, again, within the range lang gihapon siya sa ato ang string value. So, sa pineapple, ganina ito, we're showing negative 1, kay ang index 0 would be letter P. Index 1 would be letter I. Now, if we're going backwards using a negative index, mahitabuan eh, kapabali po siya. Diri siya nagsugod from the last character. Okay? But again, since we only have 9 characters in the string pineapple, pagabot na to negative 10, mahitabo ani, dili na pud sa mo allow. So, pwede mo gamit, correct na to ha, pwede mo gamit yung negative index provided it is within, ang negative value ni mo is equivalent to the ni fold yapon siya sa total number of characters. Ang only difference when you're using a negative index is pabali yung access. It's not going forward. Okay? Okay, normally, atong ginabuhat, index 0 is the first going to the size or the length minus 1. So, okay. Let's proceed. So, this is what I have demonstrated a while ago using the length. To access the length of the string, you'll have a built-in function, len. So, ibutang lang nimo as parameter, or argument rather, ibutang nimo as argument ang imong string value, okay? Or string variable, baka na siya. Okay? So, the fruit has a value banana. It is a string enclosed in single quote. So, if I'll use the len method, gipasa na to ang fruit nga variable to the len method, it would give us the total number of characters. Okay? Or the length. Or length simply means the total number of characters in a given string. So, I'll give an example. Okay? I'll stop it again. I'll clear and I'll run Python. Example name is equal to Charles Hanz V. Bautista. Okay, this is a valid string enclosed in double quote. So I could use double quote or a single quote. Okay. So let's count first without using the length method. So 1, 2, 3, 5 plus 4. Okay. 5 plus 4. No, no, 5. It's 7 plus 4. Okay. Plus duha plus 2 plus 8. So 7 plus 4, you get 11 plus duha. Can I dot? Na period. Okay. That's 13 plus 8, you get 21. Natay pila ka spaces, 1, 2, 3 ka spaces. So length method would return 24. Okay, print len, and then I would have name. That's 24. It includes the space. If I want to access the space, okay, print name at index 7. So this would give us simply one space. Kanini siya. Okay? Kanina space dere karon. Okay, if I want to access, say 12, another space. Okay? Kanina siya. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. If I want to access 13, then that would be my middle initial V. Okay? So there's a way on how to access all of these characters. What I'm showing now is we're trying to access the characters of a given string variable using the index. Okay? So how about if you want to display all the characters, then we'll be using a loop to access or to display all the characters individually later on. So again, slide number 6 talks about the len method. Sorry for the term method. Len function. Okay? Len function, which gives us the total number of characters in a given string or the length of the string. Again, total number of characters na siya. Okay? So Mr. Pasok discussed last time on functions. Now we could consider len function as a fruitful function. Why? Nagpasa ta og value. Pasa itong argument nga banana, ang len nga method, ang len nga function, nag-return, og, na siya yung value nga gi-return, which is the total number of characters. So, na-output, na siya na-return value. So, again, you could consider the len function as a fruitful function. Now, I might sa kamulo ko ga-discuss, there, sometimes nga makagamit ko sa term na method. Since I'm used to object-oriented programming in Java, method magud ang term sa function. So kanang masay ko class nga method ang gamiton, I'm still akong pasabot na class would be functions. Okay? So in this case, the len function accepts a string argument, okay? And then it returns the number of characters. So as discussed by Mr. Pasok last time, a function is some stored code that we use. So we're trying to reuse the len function. So these are more common kay ginagamit. That is why gibuhat na nag-function. Okay? So a function takes some input and produces an output. So this is the example of a fruitful function. So the kan pagyapog functions atong ma-encounter later on. So these are the basic function pa so far, no? So you have the len function gives us the total number of characters. Okay, so mura ni siya og kuan class, mura ni siya og sitaw ka na ay encapsulation bang term, encapsulation mura og na block box when it comes to using functions as discussed by Mr. Pasok, no? Why there are functions nga nganong black box man ang term, nagdag na siya something black box, is because all I need to know is how to use the function. Okay, kailangan ako kabalo lang ko unsa ang paggamit ng function, and then kabalo ko kung sa iyang buhaton, kabalo ko sa result, for example. Okay, so kabalo ko sa result nga iyang i-produce. So I'm simply using the len function without knowing how the len function counted all the characters on a given string. So na imrag black box siya murag as the diagram shows ang banana nga string gipasa nato sa len so bla 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 di natakabalo kung sa gibuhat sa len nga function atong kailangan lang mabalan is unsa yung result so there's something na encapsulation ka kahitabo wherein you don't need to know nga giunsa pagbuhat okay so example kana mga absolute value nga mga method nga functions kana mga square root nga functions so ang mga functions later on nga tong ma-encounter wherein dili nanto kailangan mabalan kung giunsa pagbuhat all we need to know is pilay parameters nga pilay argument nga tong ipasa pila ka value unsa iyang i-return type so naay mang term ana class mura og encapsulation the details is mura og it's no longer important all you have to do is you have to know kung giunsa unsa what is the requirement to use the function and what's the corresponding result okay so a function is some sort of procedure again that we use a function takes input and produces an output okay that's the len function now so we can also perform loop to strings as shown in the example so another fruit equals banana index equals 0 okay so this is now our mura og control variable to access the indices of the string banana okay so I think kabalo na mo unsa paggamit sa how to create a while loop so while index is our condition okay while index is less than length a len of fruit so the condition here is index value is 0 is less than what's the length of fruit it's 6 so the loop would execute how many times the loop would execute 6 times because the control variable here the variable that we're using is assigned 0 for initially okay so this is true letter is equal to fruit index 0 that's the first value of the index variable so giprint niya ang index at the same time the corresponding letter so that's index 0 that's letter B and the next iteration so index is equal to the next value we incremented the value of index index plus index is equal to index plus 1 mahimo niya siyang 1 so you know how the loop works so ang ginabuhat lang ani scanning from index 0 going to index 5 that's the valid index dere okay so it displays the corresponding index and the letter okay so using a while statement and an iteration variable and the len function we can construct a loop to look at each of the letters in a string individually so let's try to create this I'll use Visual Studio Code. So name, for example, is equal to. Okay. And this now. Okay, I want to get all the characters. Display all the characters I would need a variable index is equal to 0 oh, pwede po na to assign another variable ang total number of total characters total char is equal to abusing the len method sorry nabutangan ng semicolon okay len and then I pass the name variable so I could use these two variables okay while index is the same as the example is less than total char okay total char sorry execute total char so what we're trying to do here is we want to display okay print I want to display a name Okay, index, this would be index, okay, plus ano lang, name index. And then if you're using a while loop, make sure that you are incrementing the, or make sure that you are updating the value of your control variable. Okay, tendency any class, mahimo mo siyang infinite loop later on. If it's like this, ipadagan ko na. So, letter C lang siya per me. It's an infinite loop. Okay, just make sure that itong control variable, index is equal to index plus 1. So, we're trying to increment. There's a way nga maabot ko just nga sa terminating point and ito ang ato ang loop, ato ang condition rather. So in this case, so you have here, displaying it individually. Okay, so now output, so CH, you display it individually. Even the space, as you can see, there's a space here in between my first name and the last name. Okay, so this is a way of navigating. Okay, navigating atong scanning all the characters. It's like here. Okay. So kani lang yahapang gi assign to another variable instead of displaying it right away. Ang ibuhat dere is that na current trick class is that ato rang gi display diretso. So let's try to imitate unsay na buhat dere. Ah, kani lang. Comma and then index. Pwede po na siya. Okay. Ay, sorry. You have to assign this to a variable. Call that. I have here a car is equal to this one. Okay. And this one I could have here car. And then the index. Okay. So this have here CL. Okay. So as you can see, what we're trying to show you here is the corresponding indices of each the character and the corresponding index. So again, we're in atong ma scan all the elements. Or all the characters on a given string value or string literal or string variable. Okay, so print car, so the character at this particular index and in increment na punenta sa ngayon na yung mahitabo. Okay, so C0. Okay, so that's how you create a loop to scan all the characters on a given string. Okay, so but there's another simpler way of accessing all the characters, no, using the for loop. So sa while loop mangon, in our example, sa while loop atong example, it's the programmer's kwan. Ganing obligasyon ang making sure nga maabot at certain point ang maabot og termination point ang ato ang loop. Okay? So starting from zero, kanisa kilang gyud i-provide manually ni programmer. Masayop ka ani atong inanaon. So take note, when writing Python programs, the body or the block of code is specified by indentation daw, walay character ang ginagamit, just like other programming languages nga naay open brace, close brace to indicate the body of the or a code block. So sa Python man gud walay mo indicate only the correct indentation. So tanggalon ta ni, of course, infinite loop na diretso nga to ang result. So in this case, ang mahitabo ani is that there's a simpler way on how to navigate through a string using the for each nga mga loop. Okay, this example for letter in fruit, so mura kag nag declare gihapon og kanang this would serve as your mura iteration variable, your controlled variable, pero ang interpreter na ang mag iterate. Okay, it's no longer the burden of the programmer nga making sure nga iterate good siya, just like our example ngani nga kailangan sa iterate ang increment ang atong control variable, making sure nga mabot niya sa terminating point. Now sa for each mangod nga approach, this is your iteration variable, your control variable, kani siya would serve a mug scan, kani siya karon nga variable would represent all the letters or all the characters on a given string. So this example, fruit equals banana for letter in fruit. Okay, but in this case, kaning letter manggod, it's up to you on how you name it. Pwede man siya dili letter nga variable. This is simply an iteration variable. Na kuriga correspond lang po dya sa atong example nga every letter in the given string. So a definite loop using a for statement is much more elegant as compared to our previous loop nga example na using a while loop. Mas gubot ng awon ang while loop because nagdugang pagkag under variable as your iteration variable or control variable. So the iteration variable is completely taken care of by the for loop. So let's try to modify this. Okay, ato ni modify using the for car in, okay, name, okay, car in name, print, okay, car, okay, ani. So I have to clear screen, okay, or let's create another. A run. It's the same output na ganina. Okay? Only that it's more concise. Ubo ra kayo. Okay? Ubo ra kayo. And then, we'd have the same result with this loop statement here. Okay? So, kanisa, nag-declare pa taani. Nag-declare pa tag length. Or kanisa, pwede length diri. And then, you get each of the character, pero pwede lang siya i-print dead. So, okay. So, kanisa, pa na itong i-print. Now, if kailangan po nimo i-display ang index, now you have to place another variable here. But this time, ang kanilang yun siya, if index doesn't, if di na mag-bother sa index, all you have to do is when to scan all the characters, then this is more raog elegant or mas simpler pag isang approach. Now, in the example, makita niyo sa example letter niya. For letter in fruit. Now, in our example, for car in name. So, kanisa, this is your iteration variable or your control variable in the for loop. So, pwede niya bisag unsa. Pwede kali x. For x in name. Okay? For x in name, I would have to clear screen. Padagan ako, save. Padagan ako. Why? What's wrong with this? Ah, no. This should be X also. Okay. So, the same. Okay? Your control variable, your iteration variable, this variable represents every character na dayon sa imuhang given string. Okay? It serves as the every character of your given string. So, again, kung when choosing the loop, a loop nga gamiton ninyo, pwede ni gamiton. Kung serve lang ni, kung satisfy lang sa purpose, sa need, then you can use this. Or if track down pagin yung moon sang index, then you can actually get this, use this rather. Okay, so pwede na siya. Okay, so a definite loop using for statement is much more elegant as shown in the example. Mas dali gud ni siya. Okay, the iteration variable is completely taken care of the for loop. So again, tuning i comment balik ta dring example. Okay, balik ta dring example. May tabo na ani na limta na to ni. Mo limta na rig butang. Tuning i example na limtan. Okay. Delete na to na sa padaga na tong program. So, nag infinite loop na sa at character at index 1 at index 0 rather. Okay? Infinite loop na siya. Okay? So again, this is the burden. Murag pa i-look out yun siya sa programmer ang control variable dere. Masayop pa ta dere. Ang mong himong index is equal to index na indensa. May tabo ana. Infinite loop lang yapon. Kaya walay po agi with pag sulod dere, walay pa agi nga maka exit ang loop is because the value of index here will always be 0. Okay, it's index equals in this increment statement is not part of the while loop. So again, dire gid look out ni siya sa programmer ang to check whether proper ba ang pag-increment dire or nabay or di ba ta maka-encounter og infinite loop later on. So starting from 0 dapat maabot kini siyang nadyo terminating point ang ato ang while loop. So in that case we have to increment index until such time ang index equal na sila. So equal na sa length sa string. So once this becomes false, then ayha pa siya mo exit. Okay, that's how it works. Okay, so this is the comparison, no? Comparison between the two. A definite loop using for statement is more elegant. The iteration variable is completely taken care of. The for loop, as you can see, short kesa, concise, same result. Okay, kanisya. Kini siya, wala. Mas taas siya as compared. But basically, the both codes would have the same result. Okay? Same result. I modify na ito ni wherein I would no longer print the index. Okay? I would no longer print the index. Instead, I would simply display the characters. Okay? Save. I'll run it. This is the result. So I'm showing it again. Okay. So I'll comment this. Ani sa karon. Uncomment. But again, so unsa characters, for examples, in name equals, I have to print characters. Okay. Save. I'll run it again. The same result. Butang lang to, para nanti marker na. Print using for each. So basically wala gini say difference, no, when it comes to the output using while din siya for each. So for, okay, I'm gonna comment this comment. So CLS run. So using ano to? Using 4. Okay? Using 4, displaying all the characters. The same result gets ya. No difference in the output. Okay? No difference in the output. Okay? Using while, same result. So again, it's up to you on which type of loop. Again, yeah, depende muna sa problem you may encounter later on. So, whether to use for or whether to use while. Okay, let's proceed. Okay, so looping and counting. So this is an example. So word equals banana, count equals zero. So this example simply counts the letter A. Okay, letter A in a given string. So of course this would result to 3. Okay, we have 3 bananas in which kanisa. Okay, so kaning count is simply the counter every time naka-encounter sa og letter A. So this is an example. This is a simple loop that loops through each letter in a string and counts the number of times the loop encounters the letter A. So I have to modify this. Okay, pinato ni siya ma-modify class wherein I will not count letter A only, but I would count the what you call this? I would count the number of total vowels. Pinato total vowels, no? So given the name. Okay, even the name caps lock. So this one, ako lang gina-comment class ha. So given the name, we create loop, pwede for each, kani. Ang gamit, akan na lang. Okay, for each using a 4 characters in name. So I would not print name right away. Instead, I would check whether the character is a lowercase or is a consonant or a vowel. Now, my encounter na to doing a problem class is that whether we'll count a vowel or a consonant is that whether naka-uppercase siya or naka-lowercase. So, example, instead of counting the vowel man siya, letter A man siya, dere. I would modify the example. I would count the consonant, not the vowel, not letter A, the consonant. Now, ang isa nga problema class, when I'm counting the consonant, would be the case of each character. Example, kung consonant daghan ba kayo ay vowel na lang, vowel na kadaghan ta comparison. So let's make the example shorter, no? Kung consonant siya, kung vowel, I would simply compare whether it's letter A, letter E, letter I, letter O, or letter U. The problem ani is that what if uppercase or lowercase siya? So that's an additional condition, whether it's uppercase A, uppercase ani anak ng mga kwan, okay, we're trying to count the vowels. Okay, so kanisa karon, oh, there's a method, method na po lang nagamit the term. There's a function in Python wherein para mas madali akong pag-count aning vowel class or po determine regardless of the case, meaning whether it's uppercase or lowercase, ako siyang imong inani. Ako siyang convert tanan to either uppercase or lowercase. For example, name is equal to name. The name of the function is lower. Ana. Okay? So let's try to modify this. Dili na Charles Hanz itong gamitan. Instead, I'll have to... Okay, sumunan itong pangalan diya. Input... enter your name. Okay? Then, i-convert na ko sa to lowercase. Why? Para sa akong comparison dere, I will no longer compare since the problem is simply count the vowel, the vowels. Vowel ha, dili consonant. Kaya daghan kitang comparison kung consonant. Okay? Okay. So, mahitabuan eh. Before displaying, then I would have to create, okay, vowel counter is equal to 0. Okay, so I will provide an if statement. Buta naman mo ani no, if character itong gamitan, or character is equal to, okay, lowercase, take note atong gi lower, okay, a Okay. Or, okay, character is equal to E, natalin kopyahon, okay, B, okay, now na to, E, this would be U, this would be I, this would be I, no, this would be I, and this would be O, okay? So every time mag-encounter ito, inani ng mga characters, take note ato na siyang gi-lowercase, lower. Gi-lower. Sorry, I'm used to writing programs in Java. Ang termination mong good sa Java is na semicolon. So, sometimes, umutang na ito semicolon. Okay. So, sa Python, wala. Statement by statement. Or space, line separated siya. Okay, so in this case, I would have to vowel counter is equal to vowel counter plus 1. Okay. And then, I'm here. Omana tong loop. Print. Okay. Total vowels in your name. Okay. So, plus. To convert that to str, okay, vowel counter. Okay, before that, print nato, apil to print ang name para makita. Good. Okay, so I have this clear screen, save nato. Okay, enter your name. So, akong ika-percase tanong akong name or ang Bautista dili para naik. So, by simply looking at the example, pila ka vowel, that's A, E, A, tolo, A, U, lima, six, seven. Seven dapat ka vowel. So, regardless of the case, the total number of vowels is seven. Okay? So, hopefully, makita ninyo nino sa, makita ninyo sa video. Okay? Sa ato ang Visual Studio Code. Gamay kay iyang console. Okay? So, in this case, regardless, akong i-compare lang din yung class, kaya ako man siyang i-convert to lower daan. Okay? Ako man siyang i-convert to lower daan by, pwede, lahi ng variable yung gamiton din eh. Pwede siguro lowercase. Lowercase. Example ka ng lowercase para ma-differentiate nato na itong variables. Kaya name na itong i-input. At itong i-assign balik siya pero lowercase na. So, dere, pwede ito ang in lowercase diha. Pwede na siya. The same result. Okay. Ito na i-comment ang using for each. Okay. Example. Vladimir Putin. So, pilabok ang name ni vowel sa Vladimir Putin. It's 1, 2, 3, 5. So, regardless of the case, itong gi-check lang sa itong program is lowercase. Pwede po niyong gamit nun dire is instead of using 2 lower, you make it 2 upper and then kani siya uppercase letters. Okay? So, that's how lower method and a lower function performs and then napuntay gi-create dahil during a for loop which counts all the characters in a given string and then simply counts all the occurrence of vowels. Okay, so every time na can counter siya dire og vowel then you're simply counting the characters. So, atong baliktaron, how would I get the total number of consonants? Himo lang taglihi. Di lang tayo maghihap sa consonants, no? I know. Lagi hapon sa. Since na is space, you have to check. Since na is space. Napagyod siya ay napagyod siya ay period sa middle initial. Anyway, so this would basically be the same example with what is provided in the slide. Okay, so man, let's try it again. CLS total vowels. Okay, example, rumor, ayan, o, pa, so, pilaka vowels, 2, 4, 7 vowels gihapon. Okay, so again, regardless of the case, still you get the total number of vowels. Okay, let's proceed. So, proceed to the next slide. So, looking deeper into in, okay, in. So, again, murag, kuha na siya, no? This is the syntax of the for loop, for letter in banana. So, the iteration variable iterates through the sequence of ordered set, meaning our set delicas is a given string man. So, it would iterate sa tanan characters in a given string. So, the block body, okay, this one, of code is executed once each value is executed for once for each value in the sequence. So kanisya karon dire. So every value in the sequence, unsay value ani sa sequence, meaning every character in the given sequence. So daghan man siya gamit ning for loop when we go to the topics on list for lang yapon tong gamiton. Okay? So, in this case, since we're still in the topic on string, so makita na to, ma-apply na to ang for in scanning through the letters in a given string. So, the iteration variable moves through all of the values in the sequence. Okay. So, kaning iteration variable to moves through the value. So, ang letter B, gi-display niya letter B. On the next iteration, display niya ang letter A. Okay? On the next iteration, display niya ang letter N, another A, another N, another A. So, gi-scan the iteration variable. Would scan all the character. Would simply make how the iteration variable does in a for loop. Simply gets all the values in this sequence of strings. Okay? So, in ana ang gamit sa iteration variable given in the for loop. So, atong ordered set ani klase is our kaning 6 character string, kaning banana. So, whatever value atong gipasa, ibutang dere, whether a variable, okay? Whether a variable just like this, it's a variable lowercase. Now, the lowercase variable is simply the converted input nga name to all lowercase letters. Now, this is to simplify the example. So, kaniman, for character, so this is our, let's say, ano, iteration, what's it called that? Iteration variable. Okay, this is our iteration variable. So, kada character karon. So, again, you can name, sa kung sa ka variable name ni dere. Okay, pero mo ni pud imo gamiton diri sa sulod dayon. So every character, since I'm checking this character kung A ba siya or vowel ba siya, then that's the case nga ma-satisfy ni siya. Then once ma-satisfy ni, naka-encounter siya ang vowel, then you have here. So going back to this, kaning character karon would represent all the character variable, meaning would represent all the characters on the given input nga name. Okay? That's how that's how the iteration variable works in a for statement. Okay? A for loop rather. Okay. So this is how the for loop works. So, done na ba siya? Niabot na ba siya sa inatumyan ng letter? Wala pa. Okay? So, letter, okay? Wala pa na, dili pa na human. So, this would be your first letter. Okay? You print the letter. Going back, balik na po siya. Done na ba? Niabot na ba siya sa last character? Wala pa gihapon. So, this would This is a diagram or this is the flow chart of a while loop, no? Or a while loop, a loop rather. Okay, so magsig balik-balik niya, sigig print all the letters until such time na nahuman niya og scan, abot siya sa last character in the, or last letter in the given banana nga string. So, the iteration variable iterates through the string and the block body, okay? And the body of code is executed once for each value in the sequence. So every time every letter ani, so in principle class, since we have 6 characters in the string banana, therefore 6 times would execute ni siya si for loop. Okay, again, my definition of the iteration variable iterates through the string and the body of code, and the block of code is executed once for every value in the sequence. So kada value ani karon is gina-execute na to ang body sa ato ang for. So in this example, isa ra ka statement ato since we're simply displaying. Okay? So in our example, there is a, so gina-execute ni siya per me, but again, it is always not, is not executed always, it's because dili man tanan letters sa ato ang name kay vowels. Okay? So, I had po niya sa ma-execute once vowel siya. But take note, i-execute ni siya tanan, na-execute ni siya tanan sa kada character sa ato ang name nga gi-input. Example, kaning rumor ayon, i-execute ni siya tanan. Only that, wala man tayo gibuhat dere nga, wala man tayo gibuhat good dere nga, masitay ko na, lain nga code wherein nga ayang i-execute kung kuan kung dili siya tawo na kung dili siya vowel. But again, sa tanan kaning name ni nga rumor and peso, i-execute gyud siya kada character. Okay? I-execute niya tanan. Ang ginabuhat lang gyud niya, ahera siya mo execute ani. Gina-check niya tanan whether it's every character is vowel or consonant. So, kung consonant, of course, dili ni siya ma-execute. Kung vowel, ahira po ni siya ma-execute. But again, gina-check ni siya tanan. Given this code, it checks all the characters in the given string, name string. Okay? So, that's how iteration variable works in a for loop applied to strings. Okay? So, I'll be preparing another lecture video on the remaining topic on the string operation. So there are additional functions that is part of the string data type. Example, slicing strings, meaning we're simply trimming the kata, or ato ang gina, we're getting chunks of string or a subset of a given string. So, pwede na siya. So, this will be for available on my next video on string topic. That would be all.